We're asking the federal government, because they're in charge of the Bureau of Indian Affairs, to do the right thing and put the Winnemem on that list of federally recognized tribes, recognizing that they had an act of Congress, which is a federal obligation, and a promise to a tribe of people. The Winnemem history begins with Mount Shasta at the doorway coming out of Panther Meadows and coming down all the way through the McLeod River. And the basin there where the three rivers, the Sacramento River and the McLeod, come together is where the majority of the Winnemems lived out their lifetimes. However, the concern is with the river that goes all the way to the ocean because of the salmon that come up, that our concerns extend beyond those boundaries. And even the Wintu dialects and other groups of Wintu people lived along the Sacramento all the way to San Francisco. The elders have talked about when, in the early 1800s, when the first trappers came through on their way up north. And some of them, you know, left diseases here behind them when they came through, which took a lot of lives of the Wintus all along the Sacramento River, as well as partially into the McLeod River area. The United States adopted California as a state in 1850. Of course, the gold rush had began, and a lot of California Indians were killed. They were outright murdered for the gold. They were pushed from their lands. They were, you know, treated as subhuman people.
The Treaty of 1851 was also known as Treaty H. It was the treaty at Reading's Ranch, signed on Cottonwood Creek. O.M. Wozencraft and other Indian agents came out and gathered together the headmen and chiefs of the Wintu tribes, including the McLeod River Wintu, the Winnemem Wintu.
The village headmen of the Winnemems signed on to that treaty, which was supposed to set up 25 square mile reservation and provide them a livelihood. Of course, that, as well as the other treaties, the 18 treaties total in California, were put away in secrecy.
The treaties had been made, land had been ceded away, and then the California state legislature and the big robber barons, the railroad people, the timber people, the Hearst, the Stanfords, the Huntingtons, all of those people got together and said, well, you can't give these Indians this land because it's right in the heart of their timber country. It's in the heart of the rivers. It's in the heart of where the gold was being found. It was prime real estate, which the government had signed away to the tribes. And so at the urging and at the behest of California's industrial empire, the legislature here petitioned those who are representing the state in Washington, D.C. to not ratify the treaties. And so in 1852, President Millard Fillmore is on record in the Senate Journal with his vote not to ratify. And he went through each of the 18 treaties, cited the particulars of each, and then said it is hereby agreed upon that this treaty will not be ratified. And so the tribes never knew of this. And so they went along their way. The land that was ceded was taken. The great national parks, the great national forests were established by taking up these lands that were ceded by the Indians. And then the Indians were killed. They were thrown off their own land. None of the promised materials were ever delivered. None of the horses, none of the steers, none of the plows, not even the buttons or beads. And the treaties were pretty particular about what they were giving, and none of that ever arrived. the Norrell Pootis letter, as it came to be known. It was known in Washington, D.C. as the Wintuyana petition, asked what happened here, because we aren't allowed to be on our land. We can't even have the acorns because the farmers say that those are for their hogs, and my people are dying. One of the actions that was done through the Indian agents who came to the Redding area and tried to answer the Norrell Pootis letter, or the Wintuyana petition, was to provide land for them. And the tribal people in California were then allowed the opportunity to obtain allotments in what was now considered public domain land, which was in fact tribal territory. So for the Winnemem along the McLeod River, they had been living in these areas all along, and so they just made application for the original land that they held.
In 1924, Alfred Gillis and Joe Campbell went back to Washington, D.C. to say, what happened to the treaty lands? Let's get some answers here, because, you know, we're having a struggle trying to live our life. And they began to organize California. Other tribes throughout the state stepped up and joined that effort. You know, it was a statewide effort to get the government to own up to what it has done, that, you know, that it has taken California without compensation, without having to provide any services or benefits to the land that they took from those people. And so Indians up and down the state went and got affidavits. They proved who they were, that their blood lineage went to tribes, all different tribes up and down the state. The Winnemems did the same. Each area, they just took the general name, like in our area it would be Wintu. And because of that, the California Judgment Roll is like a tribal recognized role. It is the role that determined benefits for all of these California people. It determined whether or not they would have health services or education, scholarships, jobs, vocational benefits, housing. Every Indian in California was recognized by that judgment roll. And that the United States then, for services, rendering the services, declared that the state of California was on or near a reservation for services. And that was the way that things happened up until 1985.